U.S. striking Iran-backed militants in Iraq after three of our service members are hurt, one critically, in another attack on American bases. That's more than 100 attacks since October 17th. GOP Congressman and Iraq War veteran Corey Mills sits on the House of Armed Services and Foreign Affairs Committee. He joins us now. Congressman, what do you make of this response? Was it enough? And what do you make of the fact that we can't seem to stop them from these attacks? Well, thanks for having me. Look, it's not enough. And I can tell you, with 100 plus attacks that's gone on, we're now seeing where the intense attacks are starting to happen in the north, which was known as a relatively safer area in the Kurdish region. When you think about Erbil and places like the Hook and Zatko and things like this, what you're seeing, however, is an interlinking of what is also happening in Israel. So let's go ahead and look at this from a geopolitical perspective. You have Hamas, which is an Iran-backed militia, who has continued to move forward doing genocide and barbaric attacks on the people of Israel. Now you've got where the Iran-backed Houthis are starting to take attacks on the shipping lanes, and also looking at maritime and commerce distractions. Then you fast forward into Iraq again, an Iranian-backed militia, which Qatar Hezbollah is backed by Hassan Nasrallah, the head of all of Hezbollah in Lebanon, who are now trying to launch out against the West. These are continuation of terroristic behaviors by the Iranians. We have to understand that geopolitical alignment of China, Russia, Iran, and North Korea need to be a broader topic for us to be discussing, not looking at attacks as singular areas. And so Al-Hamdawi, who is the head of Qatar Hezbollah, was obviously not impacted by this, who would actually have resulted in a real impact. That was the same thing as the counter-terrorism attack by Trump when he took out Qasem Soleimani and Abu Mehdi, or Mohandas. But unfortunately, this type of attack where you're getting one-off, two-off non-militia leaders isn't going to do much when you talk about 103 attacks that's already occurred on American bases. Brian Kilme, and I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analyses. I think that every single American, as we've gone out this holiday season and we went out for Christmas and bought our turkey and bought our big Tams, things like that, we know the economy is not better. We know that the price of gas is still extremely high when you think about what it was in the previous administration. They are drowning right now with 39% approval rating in his overall job. They see exactly what is happening, and every average American knows when they stick their hand in their pocket under the Biden administration or Bidenomics, you have far less than what you had during the Trump administration of Israel. Now you've got where the Iran-backed Houthis are starting to take attacks on the shipping lanes, and also looking at maritime and commerce distractions. Then you fast forward into Iraq again, an Iranian-backed militia, which Qatar Hezbollah is backed by Hassan Nasrallah, the head of all of Hezbollah in Lebanon, who are now trying to launch out against the West. These are continuation of terroristic behaviors by the Iranians. We have to understand that geopolitical alignment of China, Russia, Iran, and North Korea need to be a broader topic for us to be discussing, not looking at attacks as singular areas. And so Al-Hamdawi, who is the head of Qatar Hezbollah, was obviously not impacted by this, who would actually have resulted in a real impact. That was the same thing as the counter-terrorism attack by Trump when he took out Qasem Soleimani and Abu Mehdi, or Mohandas. But unfortunately, this type of attack where you're getting one-off, two-off non-militia leaders isn't going to do much when you talk about 103 attacks that's already occurred on American bases. Brian Kilme, and I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analyses. I think that every single American, as we've gone out this holiday season and we went out for Christmas and bought our turkey and bought our big Tams, things like that, we know the economy is not better. We know that the price of gas is still extremely high when you think about what it was in the previous administration. They are drowning right now with 39% approval rating in his overall job. They see exactly what is happening, and every average American knows when they stick their hand in their pocket under the Biden administration or Bidenomics, you have far less than what you had during the Trump administration.